In the incidents can take in many forms, but one of the most frequent and frequent is an attack on networked computer from the outside source. The attack is one of the very common security incident happens. So most attacks involves virus, worms, Trojan horse, and denial of service. So what are the virus? Computer virus has become an umbrella term for many types of malicious code. Technically, a virus is a piece of programming code that seeks out other programs and infects a file by embedding a copy of itself inside the program. Right? So what virus does? Virus infect other file on the computer by embedding itself in the files and different files. Okay, the infected program or file, whatever, is often called virus host. So viruses needed a host. Without host, virus can't do anything. Okay, so when the host procedure runs, the virus code runs as well and performs the instruction it is instructed to perform. Understand? So somebody have developed a virus to read the victim's keyboard, and whatever the he types, the victim types, the virus reads it and sent to the attacker. So it will do that. A virus needs a host to infect. Okay. Without a host, the virus cannot replicate. Okay, so virus, so when we speak about virus, you need to remember a few things. It is nothing but a code or a programming code. A piece of programming code. First point you need to remember. Second point is it needs host. What kind of host? Host can be any file or program. Understand? And it can replicate itself. When the infected file or program runs. So these are the three points we need to remember about virus. Okay. So virus causes some unexpected and unusual undesirable event. So most viruses deliver payload or malicious act. For example, the virus may be programmed to display a certain message on the screen, delete or modify certain document, or reformat the hard disk. Okay, so you need to understand what are the malicious thing can happen. First is it can put extra payload on your system. Okay, then it may be programmed to display a certain message. It can display a certain message on the screen and delete, modify certain document. This is another thing it can do, or even reformat the hard drive. So if it reformat your hard drive, then you can understand what is going to happen. You are going to lose all the document on the hard drive. A true virus does not spread itself. Okay, so it does not spread itself from a computer to another computer. To propagate to other machine, it must be passed through email attachment, shared file, that means share some file online, or you have shared some file using some pen drive. Okay. it takes action by computer user to spread a virus. So, understand? So, like, you know, the user need to send an email, then only with that email the virus will be get attested and transmitted. Or, you know, the computer user need to transmit a file, okay, then only it can do. So it really needs some computer user's action to propagate. Then there is macrovirus. This is another kind of, you know, sub kind of virus called macrovirus. The attackers use an application, macrovirus, like Visual Basic Scripting is a kind, you know, used as a programming language, can be used to develop macroviruses. Okay, so this is a macro language, a definite programming language, macro programming, which are used for developing these macroviruses. Okay. To create programs that infect document and templates, after an infected document is opened, the virus is executed and infects the user's application template. Okay. So macros can insert unwanted word, number, phrase into a document. So this is very important thing what macros can do. It can insert unwanted phrases, words, or into a document. Okay. So after a macro virus infected user's application, it can embed itself in future documents created using the application. Say you have a word processor. Okay. You have a word processor application. Okay, which is used to generate new Word documents, text documents. It get infected by some virus. Okay, it get infected by some virus. So whatever document you will be, you are going to create using this infected application, all documents are going to be infected. So all the future documents are infected. That is. Okay. So virus is a program that can be broken into three functional parts. Three functional part it have. One is called replication, that means it can replicate itself. Okay. Then concealment, it can hide itself, and boom, that means it can explode. Here explosion means it can do whatever tasks it is instructed to do, malicious things on a user's computer or systems. Next is worm. Worm is different form of virus in that it is a standalone program. Okay. A typical worm maintains only functional copy, only a functional copy. So it is having only one functional copy. Okay. Of itself in active memory and duplicate itself. So it can duplicate itself right. They differ from viruses because they can propagate without human intervention. Propagate without human intervention. So this is the difference between the IRIS and OAuth. Okay, but it can sending copy of themselves to other computer by email, for example. So here this in case of virus, and the user need to attach an infected file to the email as attachment, then only this virus is going to propagate. But in case of worm, it can propagate, it can attach itself to email and can reach to the destination. Okay. In last few years, the boundary between worms and virus become increasingly blurry. Okay. So starting with Melissa into 1999. Melissa was a worm or virus hybrid that could infect a system like virus by modifying documents into it. Documents to include quotes from the Simpsons TV show. But it could also be used the address book of Microsoft Outlook and Outlook Express to resend itself like a worm to other clients. Okay. So who were then subsequently infected by the attached document, which might be confidential document also. Now next comes Trojan horse. I think all these things we had discussed previously. Trojan horse, I have a story of Troy, I think I had told you. In the horse, the soldiers was hid themselves, and the horse was given as a gift to the king. And in the night, the soldiers came out of the horse and attacked the palace from the inside. That is what happens in Trojan horse kind of virus. So in this case, what happens? You get some good-looking or useful app for free. So we instantly, without thinking anything, we used to download them and install on our system. But with this in the background, there may be some malicious code which can do some malicious activity on the system, which is called Trojan horse. Okay, so it is a standalone application that appears to perform some helpful natural purpose. That is what I was telling you, like PDF creator, PDF printer, all these things. Okay, but is actually performing a malicious act while the user watches the program appear to be something else. The Trojan horse does not replicate itself and does not attach itself to other file. So if Trojan horse is there on some system, it is not harmful for others because it is not going to attach itself to email or some other file and propagate to others' computers. It is only spread by those application which people are going to download and install on their system. The logic bomb is another thing. It is a type of Trojan horse which executes under specific condition. That means so the logic bomb can execute based on date and time. So that means the malicious code is downloaded today, and it is given a date and time that on 31st December, it will delete all your files. So it doesn't matter on what date we are installing it; it will be silent for that time. Okay, after that, certainly on the given date and time, it will get activated and do the malicious work. Or when you shut down your machine for 33rd time. Okay, so all these things can be can be configured, the attacker can configure it, okay, or based on typing specific series of keystroke, any event.